Hi everyone, it's Mary Fain Brandt with a LinkedIn Bakery serving up bite-sized tips so you don't get overwhelmed. Welcome to my twice a month Facebook live show. I'm super excited about tonight because I have Liz Cortes of RebelFish Local on, and she is going to be sharing some bite-sized tips on SEO, PPC, and digital ads. But before we get started, I'd love to know where you're watching from. As my audience grows, I want to make sure that I'm serving all of you. So can you just drop in the comments where you're watching from, whether it's New York, England, Australia. That's right. My network has grown, Liz. I've got this international Woo-hoo. Network now. Woohoo! Super excited. And you know what? Tell us what kind of industry you're in, because one of my natural God-given talents is being a connector. And if there's someone in my network that you need to be connected with, I want to be the person to connect you. Hey, Deborah. Hey, Marissa. So
I was just sharing
sweet.
On my phone.
Yes, that's great. You know, I used to do that too. And if anybody is watching and you think somebody needs to join us tonight because this is the information that they need to learn, jump on your phone, your laptop, and share this fabulous event while we just get ready. Oh, Kimberly is also here. Kimberly Shutters.
Hey, Kimberly. So she jumped over from LinkedIn. I know we did a lot of sharing over on LinkedIn. And right. so... I think we're taking some LinkedIn people and bringing them over here to Facebook.
Right? Like that's my two platforms is Facebook and LinkedIn. Really, those are the two that I really focus on. Not much more.
We also know Kimberly from CWENT.
Yes, we do. Hey, so I do want to give a big shout out to CWENT. That's Christian Women's Entrepreneur Group, and Liz and I first met. There, we were sitting next to each other, and literally, I'm not even joking, Liz. I turned to her, we were like, I think we're just sitting next to each other on the couch. And I knew at the end of that meeting that Liz and I, we were going to be friends. Like, it was just, I don't know how to describe
yeah,
it.
Yeah, then we became even better friends at the CWIN retreat. And we were like,
oh, that's right, we walked in together.
Let's go do the homework together. And we went and got this like cute little bench by this little stream, and we did the homework together
That's
and had
right.
some really good moments sharing about our business and life. And that was
yeah.
when we like
That's
really
awesome.
Clicked.
So you know what? There's a life lesson. You just never know when you're going to meet someone that's going to be part of your business plan and a friend and a colleague. So I would consider Liz a good friend, not just a colleague. So high five.
Awesome.
Okay. So Liz, why don't you tell the audience a little bit about your company and how you got started? Because I always like to know the backstory.
Yeah. So my husband and I, Robert, we started RebelFish Local 3 years ago. And this was our first time to be in business together. At the beginning, it was a little challenging. I was used to my own business. He was used to his own business. And then to come together and be in that dual relationship of being married as well as business partners, it was a little tough, but we've been working alongside each other for 3 years, and we have really grown, and now I wouldn't trade it for anything. I love to encourage other husbands and wives to work together and support each other, because you're married and you have different strengths and weaknesses, but then when you can like work through those and then come together, you can totally build something that just was really great. It's going to make a big difference. And so we work with local businesses primarily, and we help them manage their three most critical lists. So helping you manage your email list, your social media list, your pixel list, which we'll be getting into what a pixel
I don't know what a pixel list
later
is.
On.
That's something
yeah, we'll
that
get into that a little later. But pixel list is really, really important because 96% of people leave your website without calling you or without buying mm-hmm. something. So when you're building a pixel list, you can connect with those people that left your website. And we'll talk about that a little bit later. And then we wrap it all up and we're able to market your reputation, your 5-star online reviews, so that you can have more customers or clients or patients.
Now that I do know about because you did show us how to get those 5-star reviews in one of the workshops I attended. And then I actually applied what you taught us, and I have over 20 5-star reviews on my Facebook page, and I literally got those in a month. Like,
Yeah, you did amazing.
thank you. So listen to my girl, Liz, because she knows what she's talking about. Listen to her, take notes, and then implement what she tells you. So, yeah, and I love that you and Robert work together. So, Joe, my husband, so Joe and I and Liz and Robert have hung out together before, and I love hanging out with couples, Christian couples also that have worked together, because actually, you know, our goal, Joe and I, is to grow my business where he actually comes and works part of the business. He'd probably be like the accountant managing like definitely managing the finances, keeping me on a budget, and processes. That's where his strengths are. So that's our goal, so that we can work together side by side and not pull our hair out though.
Yeah. Well, I could definitely help you with that. Knowing each other's strengths and your Myers-Briggs and your Enneagram, that's what's really helped us.
Awesome.
Focus.
Well, let's just dive in and let's start talking. I don't know where you want to start. I don't know the order of importance. Like, do we need to start with SEO or PPC or this pixel thing? Like, you're the expert, so you tell me where you want to start sharing with the audience. Like, my audience is entrepreneurs. We have a whole bunch of entrepreneurs on right now. So, yeah. And I'm going to say they're small to mid-size. So where do we start, Liz, if we're building traction? Like, you know my story, so you know where I'm at, and I'm building that traction, right? And I'm getting busier. So, but where do I start when I want to grow a little more? Like, is it SEO? Should I do that first before the PPC?
Good question. Yeah. So traffic. So let's start off with, you know, identifying traffic and why it's crucial for your business. Without traffic, without people coming to your social media or coming to your website, what's the other way to get customers? You'd have to go and see them in person or go to a networking group or something like that, which could take a lot more time, which those are amazing. You definitely want to always be doing that, but you can get customers that are coming to you, coming to your website, finding you by them doing a Google search or seeing an ad and going to your website, going to your social media. So traffic is very, very critical to your business, because if you don't have traffic, you're not in business.
Yeah.
At all. So you definitely want to be having traffic. And so the first thing you really want to look at when it comes to traffic is you want to ask yourself a couple questions. First of all, you want to know how many customers or patients or clients do you work with on a monthly basis?
Okay.
So identify what that number is. On a monthly basis, I work with this many customers.
So like currently, this is how currently. Many I'm working with.
Okay. All right. So maybe it's 5, maybe it's 3 if you're working full-time and doing your business on the side, you know, could be 3, but identify what that number is. And then identify how much they're paying you on a monthly basis or a yearly basis if you multiply that by 12. And that's going to really motivate you when you know those numbers to be able to look at the traffic, you know, and how did they come to you? Were they referrals? Did they come through your website? Did they come through social media? So the next step when it comes to traffic, because traffic typically is you're going to send, if you're paying for any advertising, you're going to be sending people to your website.
Right.
Or even Facebook ads. You could be sending them to your Facebook business page too, but we'll focus pretty much only website. On your website for today.
I always tell everyone the name of the game on LinkedIn is to get them off LinkedIn and onto your website, right?
So absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. You want to get them over to your website. And so when you are getting that traffic, you know, at first it's going to be slow, but it's so important to have your Google Analytics code connected on there so you can know what your monthly organic visitors are. Do you have that? Make a note.
Are you taking a note? I'm taking a note. But now I just got an email, and I got that email from Google saying how many people visited. So am I set up then?
Yes, you're set up.
That took me forever to get set up then, because I'm just starting to get that. I think I've received it twice now. So I'm on the right track somehow.
You are on the right track, right. And for us, we use like WordPress as the website that we have. So it's connected. So in the back of your WordPress when you log in, and it kind of is probably similar no matter if you're using Wix or Squarespace or any of those other website providers, you can like typically log into the back end and see what those numbers are. And it is really important. You could see like super like in-depth analytics, but just knowing how many unique visitors are coming. Like I met with a client last month. He is a mortgage broker and he gets 120 unique visitors per month coming to his website. And when they get on the phone with someone that calls, 80% of them choose to use them to further loan. So I was like,
wait, stop right now. So you say that they actually still get on the phone. I just want everybody to take a note of that. The old fashioned phone still works once you get them to your website.
Right. Absolutely.
Okay.
And yeah, getting on the phone is where you definitely want to be. I think a lot of people think it's cool to have all like the emails and the landing pages and the funnels, all of that looks really cool. But especially if you're selling higher ticket stuff, like a coaching program, you want to get them definitely on the phone and they'll be able to do. So traffic is so critical. And what is so cool about right now in 2017, last year, that was the first time where digital online ads and marketing surpassed television advertising.
What?
First year ever for it to surpass. So this is where the trends are moving. It's not a trend. It's not going to go away. But now advertising online has surpassed television advertising.
So wait, so we don't have to have the money to like have those big TV ads. You see, what is it that, you know, the paid ads where the skincare and the hair stuff, brought
infomercials.
Yeah, the infomercials, right? So we don't need to worry about being big enough to be over there on TV. All we need to do is focus on the digital ads and we are going to blow up.
Absolutely. You got it. You got it.
Oh, Marissa has a comment. She says phone and in person is still key. You're right, Marissa. I totally believe in, you know, having that conversation. But we got to get people to want that conversation, right, Liz? So
right,
kind of have that warm lead. So if they're already on our website and they're already looking into our products and service, that's where Liz comes in to drive that traffic, as she says, to our website. And then that Google analytic part, right, about seeing who's visiting and how many visitors and then reaching out on the phone, which I am really bad at that. And I think I need to go back to that. Thank you for those tips. Okay.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. So you mentioned, you know, what do I do first? There's typically three ways for you to drive traffic to your website, which you mentioned them earlier. You said it's PPC, which is pay-per-click, SEO, which is search engine optimization, and the third one is digital ads. So those are the three. So I'll just go into each of them so you understand how they kind of work, and then that will help you decide which one's best for you. So let's talk about SEO first. Now, SEO, we do a lot of local SEO campaigns for our clients. We know how to do this, but with SEO, it is a long-term strategy. When we're working and doing an SEO campaign for our clients, we say, you know, don't expect to get to page one for your top keyword until about 9 months.
Nine months?
That can happen before, but typically about 9 months. And so you're paying on a monthly basis, and typically it could be $1,000 to $1,500 a month for an SEO campaign. So it's expensive and it is also a long-term strategy, but it works because once you get there,
Do you stay up there or do you have to continue?
You have to keep continuing to do it because the placement changes. But once you like get on certain pages, some of them aren't going to disappear, even if you stop doing like your SEO service. But we're not here to talk a ton about SEO because it's expensive and it takes a long time to do. The second thing that you can do is PPC. So PPC, that's using Google AdWords, that Google network. And that is where you go to Google and you are searching for a keyword. Let's say you're looking for
like LinkedIn trainers or
like LinkedIn trainer or
LinkedIn speakers.
Yeah, you could look up that. You could look up any of those. Or maybe you have a tooth that fell out and you need to get a dental implant and you lost your tooth and you're in really bad pain. So you type in dental implant San Diego. Well, if you type that in, that person probably wants to get an implant. So we call that like a money keyword. They are probably wanting to buy something soon because their tooth is hurting and they need to get a new one. However, at the top on Google, you'll see the ad there. That's the Google ad. And then on the side, those are those ads. But when you click on it, you as the business are paying per click. So every time someone clicks for dental implant San Diego, that's actually $40 per click.
What?
So again, it's super expensive. And so a lot of small business owners, you know, you can't, that's not in your budget. Like that's just, it's crazy.
$40. Is that straight across the board? Like if I wanted to do an ad campaign, it's $40 or dentist $40. Are there different price points? How does that work?
Yeah, it's totally different, right? It depends on the competition. So if more people want to be found for those keywords, then they're going to bid higher. And
oh my gosh. So it's like a bidding war too? Oh
yeah, but you know, on Facebook, you are paying per click or through impressions. You could do it that way too. So if you do Facebook ads, it's kind of similar to that where you are bidding and you're trying to figure out how much do I bid so that they can show my ad. So I don't know if you guys have done Facebook ads and sometimes they didn't spend your whole budget, you know?
Right. Or I've had that happen.
You didn't get approved, but if you increased up your bidding price, you maybe could get approved. And so it's kind of the same thing over there. So again, PPC, that can be expensive. And most people don't know how to do PPC. We have some staff that does it for our clients that are amazing at it.
Yeah, I don't know how to do it.
But again, like typically if you hire an agency, your ad spend needs to be at least $2,000 to $3,000 a month. That's just for the ads. That's not including the management of the campaign, which could be around, you know, $500. And so again, it's expensive and you have to have a large budget to be able to do that. So that's why I'm excited to talk to you guys also about the third way.
Tell us the third way, because these other two ways seem like they're for the more the medium to large business, right, which is great, you know, or the businesses that have been established and, you know, they're really established, so they don't need, I mean, they just have a bigger marketing budget. Let's be honest. The entrepreneurs, solopreneurs, why we want to invest in our companies, right? I think I want to just put it out there that I know I need to invest in this to grow my business. So you guys, if you're at that point right now where you're like, your business is, it's churning like this, but you're like, I know I could have more business. I'm at that brink where I need to grow. This is probably a really good technique or tip that Liz is going to share for us, because I know we don't have $5,000, $10,000 to invest in our marketing, right? That's a lot of money for the solopreneur, or at least probably for this audience. But we know we need to invest in some online digital ads and marketing. So Liz, tell us what you think would be good for me. You know me and you know my business, so.
Yeah, so the third way that you can get traffic to your website is through digital display advertising. And I'll get into the two different versions of digital display advertising. Now, before I jump into that, I want you to just understand, when you are doing digital display advertising, you are not paying for clicks.
Okay.
You are paying for the amount of times your ad is going to be shown. So let's say you go to foxnews.com and you see some ads at the top, you see ads on the side, or you're reading a blog and you see the ads in the blog. That's the advertising I'm talking about. So these are on real websites. These could even be on blogger websites. You can also do digital display advertising on apps on your phone.
Ooh, I like that.
Which is pretty cool too. So you can do the mobile version of them for websites. You can do desktop version for websites, as well as mobile phone apps or iPad apps, which is cool. So with digital display advertising, you are paying for an impression. That's not a click. And typically it could range between $25 and $50 for 1,000 impressions. So you're able to get way more out there. But the one thing is, you don't know if that $25 for those 1,000 impressions, you don't know if you're going to get 25 clicks by people clicking on those. You might get 50 clicks. You might get 0 clicks. So that's where it comes in, you know, with tweaking the ad, changing things around so that people click. So
you need to have a really good ad then, like visually inspiring, motivating, and appealing, I would think.
Right, right. And I'll get into three types of ads in a little bit. And
I'm so excited
first,
right now.
Before I jump into that, I want to tell you about the two different types of digital display ads. There is retargeting ads and cold traffic. Okay, we're small businesses. We're not going to worry about cold traffic right now. I want to really focus on the remarketing, okay? Cold traffic, that means that you're just putting an ad up on a website, Typically, it'd be a place where your customers are hanging out. Maybe they're going to that blog. Maybe they're going to a networking site and they're checking it. Maybe they're going to these different places. You put your ads straight up on that website and you bid to get over there. That's cold. But again, that takes a bigger budget. What is the way more affordable way to capture 100% of your visitors that come to your website is to do remarketing ads. And so when someone comes to your website, I said earlier that 96% of people leave your website without calling you, without buying anything, without opting into something on your website. If you have free offers, they leave. So that can be really frustrating, but you are able to capture 100% of those people that come to your website, and that's through a pixel. A pixel is a little code that goes onto your browser that follows them around as they're going around the different websites. And so, for example, you go to Amazon Prime, okay, and you're looking for, let's see, what's something you bought? About the last thing I bought.
My light.
Your light. Oh, yeah, the ring light. Okay, so you go to the ring light page, and you're like, oh, that's pretty expensive. I'm not ready to buy that yet, but I want to save it for later. And then you go to Facebook, and then now the ring light ads are showing up there. That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, who else has experienced that? You're online. So I kind of feel like there's a leprechaun online that's following me around, right? And they're following me around on Amazon and all the different websites, because anyone that knows me knows that I am an Amazon Prime junkie. There, I'm admitting it. I love Amazon Prime, right? High five. Woohoo! High five for Amazon Prime.
I had two friends with birthdays. They all got their presents through Amazon Prime.
My niece's 16th birthday, I kind of forgot that I needed to get her something and she's not here. So I went online and it was like Saturday. Her birthday was on a Tuesday. And I surprised her with a beautiful Tiffany's necklace.
Fancy.
For 16, I was like, well, I can't buy her a car, so I'll buy her a fancy piece of jewelry that she'll never forget. But I think that was kind of wrong because I have 1, 2, 3 more nieces. So I've set the standards high. But anyway, so I love Amazon Prime. So you're telling me this little leprechaun, I'm calling it a leprechaun now because it's almost St. Patty's Day, right? A leprechaun is following us around. A pixel is actually a leprechaun that follows you around from one website to the next. And that's when those pop-up ads. So, for example, if someone maybe was looking, like I was doing career coaching, right? So they're looking for a career coach, you know, and then I could target them. It would kind of be like targeting.
Right. So the people that come to your website, the ones that get a pixel put on to their browser that follow them around, that is what is your pixel list. So each month, let's say on average, I'd say most people here probably are getting around 100 to 150 unique visitors that come to your website every month. Okay.
What?
So that's great. So think about if this month had 100, next month now your pixel list grew to 200, the next month 300, 400, 500. Then by the end of the year, you're at over 1,200 pixels have been dropped throughout the year. So that's pretty great to be marketing to those people who came to your website already, but they maybe didn't give you a call. Maybe they didn't find what they were looking for. So what you're able to do and what some other, why small businesses haven't been doing this, you know, as much until now is because it used to be really expensive because only the big advertising agencies would offer services. Because when you are setting up your retargeting campaign, now that's a retargeting campaign to only market to those people that already came to their website. They already looked and saw your branding. They maybe read some of your stuff, but they left. So it's so great for branding, but when you are doing a retargeting campaign, you can do it on a very small budget, and it's like less than what you'd be doing to send out postcard advertising.
What?
You can do that with online. And now agencies like us, we put together great packages that are way more affordable because other bigger agencies that have been doing advertising, you know, 20, 30 years, these huge ones, they typically don't work with small businesses that have a small budget or less than $500 to spend a month on their advertising, their marketing, stuff like that. They can't do it. And so this was just what I've been loving. I've been talking about this We've been doing retargeting for clients for about a year and a half now, and it just is so cool to see more smaller business owners being able to do advertising and
so
be
what
able
type
to play.
Of, I love this. Like, I'm super excited right now about pixels. I'm like, I don't understand them totally, but like, I just want to pixel the heck out of my marketing plan.
Awesome.
Tell us some of the types of, you know, without your sharing your clients' names, like, what are some of the types of businesses that you have worked with that might resonate with our audience here tonight?
Yeah, so we have worked with clients of dentists. Well, you said they're all on, like, probably online, mostly online. We haven't worked a ton with online, but we are talking with someone who has a book on Amazon and a Bible study series. They're thinking about doing this. We haven't personally done it. We've worked with mortgage brokers.
Okay.
We've worked with marketing agencies. We actually, with all of our clients, when they become a client, we make sure they're set up on Google Analytics always, and we start building their pixel list as soon as they become a client of ours. Even if we're not going to be doing traffic for them, maybe that's not in their package, we do that as a service so we can start building that pixel list. So within 3 months, 6 months, a year later, they decide, hey, you know what? I want to start doing traffic. We've already built up a pixel list. So even if you aren't, able to start doing this yet, you can still put a code on your website so you can start gathering
it. So we can start,
but
like,
then you're
preparing.
Not turning on, right? Then you're not turning it on yet. So you can create a pixel through your Google Analytics, like your PPC account, or Facebook has a pixel. You can do those are two different ones. That gets all fancy. I don't want to get too much into the technical.
No, stuff. So, but like one of the things that we can all do tonight is to create that pixel code or whatever it is. Once again, that's not my tech expert. Liz and her husband, Robert at RebelFish, you know, if you need help with this, you want to go there. But we can actually, even if we're not ready to like tonight, sign up and say, Liz, we want to hire you to do this, but we know we want to do it and we might have to build it into our budget. We can start with getting that pixel code built in. And then when we're ready, come to you. And it's kind of like being ahead of the game.
Yep, exactly.
Oh my
exactly.
gosh. That's an awesome tip.
Yeah, so you can start doing that and, you know, even you can, like, Google, like, videos or go on YouTube and you can, if you want to just get started on this yourself, you don't have a budget to hire a company to do it, you just want to do it yourself, there are videos on there. I don't know of any good ones, but there's videos on there you could, like, check and you could get started maybe just, you know, on doing
just turning
Facebook
the pixel,
retargeting.
Just
trying it, yeah.
Well, I just want to turn the pixel on, but I want to hire you guys to do that.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
I'd love to help you out.
You know, I did a whole series in January of time management and, you know, going through your apps and programs and kind of, I called it dump, delete, or delegate. And so that was the whole series in January because as entrepreneurs, we're usually a party of one. Maybe we have an intern or a VA. That's great. But still, our time and our resources are so limited. But what I always tell entrepreneurs is in order to grow, you have to outsource. You need to work in your, what do they call it, to work in your zone or where you shine. So I'm a trainer. I'm a teacher. I love tech. But you know what? It would take me weeks to figure out the pixel thing. In the time I would try to figure it out, I'd be missing out on speaking, working with clients, doing my LinkedIn lab. So we all have to choose, like, when is it the right time for us to invest in our advertising and marketing? And I know there's some people watching right now. I'm like, yeah. They're ready. They're about to, they're at that point where they're not going to grow and explode where they want to be without having some targeted marketing. And I think pixels might be just a great way to get, you know, just that bit of growth that we're all looking for.
Mm-hmm.
I love
Absolutely.
This. I am so excited. Can you tell?
Absolutely.
I'm
I love it. Woohoo. I'm glad it's starting to click and make more sense because using some of these words and jargon just gets like confusing and just, it's just a technical, block that comes up. So I'm glad that you're getting it. I'm glad that people are watching are getting it too. And going back to that postcard example. So I don't know if anyone has done any advertising where you did flyers or you did mailers, but typically when you do those, you send them out to a zip code and you are sending them to spending thousands of dollars and you're sending them to random homes.
Right. And you don't even know who lives there.
You don't know who lives there. You don't need know if they need your products or your services. And you have people that are coming to your website every single day. And those people, if they're coming to your website, they probably need your products and services. And they just need to be reminded of you. So that's why
top of
having
mind.
A retargeting campaign, you can stay in front and be branded and you can stay connected with them. And typically, they're thinking, well, how long does this campaign run? We have tried out doing a 6-month retargeting ads campaign. And what we found is that a 3-month campaign of marketing them, that's what works out best, because those people that come to your website, they're coming for typically 3 different reasons. Some people come to your website because they are looking for a good deal. I like good deals. You know, they may be looking for a good deal. And so that's why it is very important that you have something on your website that could be a good deal, your free offer, a discount.
Yes.
Or if you don't want to offer something to everyone, like we just did we created this ad campaign for a special, but they're like, we don't want our other clients to come back and ask for a refund.
So what do you do?
Deal. So we created a private page on their website so that when the people click on that ad, when they are doing retargeting, they click on the ad, then they go to that private page that has that special that maybe that is what that person was looking for, a good deal. Another type of ad and another type of reason someone comes to your website is because they are looking to do business with a reputable company. So they want to read online reviews. Right. So you can have online review focused ads. And then the third reason is they are looking for a specific product or service. So those are more branding focused on what you offer. And so if you have all 3 of those on your website and you have those 3 types of ads, you are going to most likely get those people to come back. And of those 3 types of ads, which one do you think performs the best? So we have
the opt-in
offer. We have the offer ad. We have the product or service or the discount offer ad or the product or service ad or the reputation focused ad. Which of those 3?
Does anyone want to comment here?
What do you guys think?
Let's see. Someone put a comment. So Liz is asking us, which ad do you think performs better? The opt-in ad, the service ad, or the reputation ad? Anybody?
Yeah. So which one do people typically click on and come back to your website because they see it while they're surfing the internet somewhere?
I'm waiting for someone to comment. So let's just come on, somebody comment. Okay, so I originally said opt-in, but I'm gonna retract that statement. I don't know. I'm torn. I'm like opt-in.
So you think it's the offer, the discount, the offer, free gift,
or the reputation? It's got to be one of those 2. It's not the service. I feel like, you know, I get so much of my business from referrals.
You got it. You're right.
Yeah.
You're actually, I've asked this to like so many people and everyone always says the discount offer. The discount offer is what people click on. And that is what I always thought too. But from doing these campaigns for 1.5 years for multiple companies and different industries, every single time, the ones that outperform are the reputation ads.
Okay.
They already came to your website. They already came there. They see your logo on the ad. They read that review or see a cool picture of someone happy. They right. click on it. It goes to their website. They're like, oh yeah, I know this person. I already went to this website. You remind them, you stay in front of them. And it is just so cool that's why it's so important for you to get online reviews and to use those online reviews. Don't just let them stay there on Yelp right. or Facebook. Use them, which you did that today. I saw on your Facebook, you shared your online review.
Winnie so Wednesday.
Yeah. So those are the 3 types of ads. And then the other thing you want to avoid is banner blindness, okay? So you can think of when you go to Amazon and you keep seeing the same light over and over again, the same image. It doesn't change. It kind of gets annoying. You feel like you're being stalked. It doesn't feel very good when you keep seeing the same image over and over and it's all on these other different websites. It's weird. It's kind of creepy. So what we found that works really well is not only to do a 90-day retargeting campaign for those people that come to your website that got the pixel, but also in that 90 days to show them 10 different types of ads.
Oh, so they're like, ads. I've seen that.
Right, exactly. So you want to give them 10. Wow. So of those three, so we talked about offer, we talked about branding ads, and we talked about reputation ads. What has worked really good is to do three offer ads, three branding ads, and four reputation ads, because the reputation converts higher. But you need to have a blend of all of those, and you kind of, you put them in different orders, and some of them we show for 2 or 3 days. Some of them we keep up there for 5 to 7 days. We have it kind of dialed in, but that will kind of give you an idea of what's really working. And our clients are getting amazing, like, clicks going back to their website. And then it gives them opportunity to go back, find what they're looking for, pick up the phone, make that appointment, schedule a consultation or whatever, get your free gift. So does anyone have any questions?
Kimberly says, do you recommend doing the same with the LinkedIn headline photos? Kimberly, I think you mean the LinkedIn background banner that's behind the photo. You can't actually have a link in there, though.
I get what she's talking about. She's talking about how your background cover photo on social media is kind of like an ad also.
Right.
Like she's probably seen some of my trainings where I talk about it's a billboard, yes, too. So yeah, that is kind of like an ad. It's not going to, you can't click on it and go to your website, but you can have offer focus covers. You can have branding focus covers or reputation focus covers. And which are the two that you recommend on LinkedIn the most?
Reputation, right? And call to action.
Call to action.
I have my reputation banner is up right now that Liz's business did. And then I have my second set is call to action, which should be coming up soon because I'm going to be switching things up and offering a really fun recipe for success course.
Yeah. So that, I'd say that's probably the first place. If you're going to start doing any type of advertising, you want to make sure, like, and you don't have a big budget, that's one place where you could start is, you know, come up with a branded cover that goes on all social media, that matches with your website, that looks good, that's either an offer, a branding, or a reputation.
Be consistent.
Focus. Right. And then the next phase, if you are ready to start doing some traffic and doing some advertising to those people that come to your website, that's really targeted, focused traffic, then that's when you can go to the next phase is let's, you know, create that, we call it a 10X retargeting campaign, where we create those ads and do all that stuff for you.
So I have a question because, and I always ask things that are relevant in my business, of course. So I love this pixel thing. Like I'm super stoked to learn more about this and have a better understanding about where I'm going to be investing my money. But I have a specific question. So what if you want to target just for a specific product? Let's say an online course. Let's say you just want to advertise that. You're not looking for one-on-one clients, right? Is there a way to do that, or is that a different type of marketing?
Yeah, so you could have your online course be part of your retargeting campaign, but if you are doing a promotion, let's say a 2-week or a 1-month promotion, whatever your promotion is for your online course, you can do the other type of digital display ads, which is called cold traffic ads. So those, you're putting them up on certain websites. If you are doing, you could also be specific to what are people searching, like for you having a LinkedIn course. If you know what that search term is, you could run a PPC campaign for whatever that those keywords are. But again, it's probably going to cost you a lot more money.
Okay.
It's a lot more affordable to be paying for impressions because you could be spending, you know, $25 to $50 for 1,000 impressions versus PPC. I didn't look at the LinkedIn keywords, the price, but it could be $10. It could be $40 per click. So it's expensive. So same thing on like your Facebook ads, you can target and get them specific to, what people are interested in, and you can get fancy with it. But we've just found that doing this has been really great and doing cold traffic ads. So like right now for some dentists, there's a special going on with Invisalign, and I feel like it's nationwide. I don't think it's just with like our dentists, but, when you buy Invisalign, you get a free retainer. So that's an example of a promotion that is only for this month of March. And I don't know how many dentists, I feel like it's nationwide. I don't know. I didn't Google it, I just pay attention to ads and what other people are doing, and then I bring it to my clients like, hey, let's think about doing this promotion because other people are running ads for it.
Got
so let's
it.
tap in. So that's something where it goes till the end of March for a few dentists that I saw online, and that would be a short-term promotion to do that you could run ads to, kind of like what you would do for your LinkedIn course.
Okay, that's helpful. So you know what? We're over time. Usually we do a 30-minute, but you know, this is such a hot topic, and Liz has such great tips for us that we're a little over. But I just want to ask the audience, do you have any last-minute questions that you want to ask? And also, I want to let you guys know that you can totally engage with Liz in the event page. She'll, you know, you can ask a question that you forgot. She'll help answer questions, and just you can connect with her on LinkedIn. So somebody says sizzling. Hey, that's one of my terms. That's right.
Woo-hoo.
Sizzling secrets. But it has been so great having you on, and I just can't wait to start my Pixel campaign because that's going to be happening soon. And I just want to thank you and Robert for the good work that you're doing in your business, helping entrepreneurs, and what you're doing in, we have another comment. Oh, Denny.
Oh, hey, Denny.
And Kimberly says, great content, resource, and excellent speakers. Thank you, Mary and Liz. Well, thank you, Kimberly.
Thank you. Mwah. Thank you.
So, Denny.
Yeah, and if you guys want, did Denny have a question?
Well, Shelly Mitch says, thanks for all the great info. No, Victor says, yes, with a fire. So Victor's interested in services with you. But Denny says, does Liz have an offer?
I do.
Denny, we were getting to that. Didn't you feel the buildup?
Denny is a really awesome marketer too.
Awesome. Well, Denny, thanks for joining us. I'm so happy that you were able to jump on here. And Liz, so what do you have for our audience tonight?
Yeah. So I shared about earlier, just, you know, how you can get started with doing retargeting and getting your pixel built for less than $500 a month for doing that.
Right.
That includes your ads. That includes your management of them. That includes the ad spend, all of it all together. So it's definitely a way more affordable way to get started. And that special pricing that I have for you guys and the people that are watching this video. And if that's something that you would like to learn more about, I would love to sit with you, you know, one-on-one and actually go through a PowerPoint presentation and show you pictures of what I'm talking about. So today, I don't know if you took notes, but it's night, it's late. We'll go back over it a little slower. I'll show you beautiful pictures, and then I'll go over, you know, what does that whole 10X campaign look like for you, for your specific industry? And I just spoke at a speakers conference last week, so I had a very diverse group in there, and they really love that training. And so that's the training that I'll go more in depth in and show you pictures, go more into depth of what I talked about, and then share. You can come on as one of our clients if it's a good fit for us or for you. So if you're interested in that, you want to, you know, go through another training, or if you have some questions for me, we can set up a call. But if you go to rebelfishlocal.com/retargeting, that is where you'll be able to schedule a call with me. And then we will help you whether you're just learning and you want to learn more, you're not ready to buy, that's totally fine. I will totally meet with you. I don't care. You know, if you want to just learn, but if you are someone that does have that $500 a budget for a month to do something like this, and you want to learn if this is where you want to invest that money,
right,
instead of a PPC or SEO, I'll definitely sit down with you too and go more into detail how this would look like for you and what results we can get.
I love that. So it's not just about signing up. It's about educating us. And mm-hmm. I love that because I don't care where I'm spending my money. And I'll share like a funny story. Years ago when the digital cameras came out, I like researched them for 6 months. I was spending $500 and I was like, that was a lot of money like 10 years ago for the camera. And I was like, I researched them on, what is that, CNET and Google. I was all over the place because I wanted to educate myself before I spent that money. And I think that this is wonderful that Liz is like, hey, I know I shared a lot of information. She has a very busy schedule, a big client list, but she's like, hey, I want to educate you and we want to make sure it's the right decision for you right now. And so that's being a heart-centered entrepreneur, which I love about you and Robert. And I think this is a wonderful opportunity for you all learn a little more about what that campaign would look like for your business. And then you can make the decision if now is the right time, is that the right type of campaign for you? Or maybe it's something you want to build into your budget and you have an upcoming special like my online course. Like, I know that this is something I would want to do. So thank you so much. Everyone is like high fives, hearts, thumbs up. So tons of engagement, and you'll be able to see all of that over on my Facebook page, Mary Fane Brandt Coaching and Consulting. And just a couple quick reminders. So my next LinkedIn Lab is March 21st, 4:30 to 6:30 p.m. at Hera Hub. And the LinkedIn Lab is 2 hours of intense time of you guys working on your profiles or your summary, building your connections, creating your first post. But more importantly, it's about working side by side so I can answer your questions right there. There's a lot of new features coming out on LinkedIn. There are some new things that are coming back. They're being revitalized. So every month at my LinkedIn training, I'll go over what the latest, greatest things are on LinkedIn. And then basically it's not me talking, I swear. It's you guys working on your laptops, getting the work done. So if you're interested in coming to my lab this month, I would love to see you there. And I will put the link down below. It's $49. It's super affordable. And then also, I'm thinking about doing a virtual lab. So watch for a poll on that here, because I want to get some feedback and see what you guys want, because I'm really here to serve you. So that's it for tonight, because we went over time, but it was fabulous. Oh, hey, Lisa. Lisa came on. Lisa's in Virginia. She was one of my.
Oh, yeah, Lisa.
Lisa Hill.
Social media for realtors.
Yeah, she was in my. You did her. Did you do her banner?
I did a cover for her.
Yeah. Yeah, she was one of the students in my class. So, hey, Lisa, thanks for tuning in. So, Liz, I love you guys. Thank you so much for taking the time. And Victor says thank you. So I'm going to say goodbye, because we would just sit here and chat. And there's a lot of engagement going on right here in the Facebook Live. So high five. Okay, thanks, guys. See you next time.